Tonight, Mr. McCormick, a.k.a. Mac, me, Mr. Nelson, a.k.a. Nelly, and Lieber, a.k.a. Lieber, will be playing True Confessions. Each of us have a piece of paper in front of us. One is true and one is a lie. We will interrogate each other and figure out if the statement the individual reads is true or a lie. So, Mr. McCormick, you're going to start. I'm going to pick the number. So why don't you hold those up so everyone at home can see those?
The number one and the number two?
Yeah. Okay. I am going to go with number two.
All right.
Let's hear this.
I went ahead and got sun today, so you guys couldn't see me blush. I'm one of those.
You look very nice, and you're glistening very well on your screen.
You know, glistening. See that little? It's right there.
Now, I got to make sure, look into the camera, too, so we can really read your facial expressions to know if it's a lie or true.
Can you see my eyes?
Yeah, they're beautiful.
Okay. Well, I have to read the paper, though. So.
Right. Okay.
Here we go. All right. I have not missed a televised Bears game since 1997.
Have not missed a televised Bear game since 1997.
What game? When was the last game you missed?
The last game that I missed?
Yeah.
1997?
Yeah, but what game? Like, do you remember what game it was?
Freshman in high school. Had to go up to Wisconsin because my grandma died. So I missed the game.
See, like you said, your grandma died, so it's really hard to jab at that. Like, I was going to say, like, did you have a date or something? But then you threw in your grandma dying, which kind of throws
that
off.
Well, who goes on a date on Sunday at 12 o'clock? That's a hard date spot.
Yeah. Well, who has a funeral, too,
on a Sunday?
Let's not get into it. No, we're not going to get into Mr. Lieber's dating life.
Well, I was just going to ask him because he's – as I've been on a date.
That's a good point. Yeah, but not as a freshman in high school. You're not going on a date at noon.
But
on a
my grandma lived in Wisconsin, in Beloit, Wisconsin. So it was a weekend ordeal.
Was she a Bears fan?
No. Packers. A lot of my family, which you know, my mom and dad are both from Wisconsin. So
okay, so here's one thing that I'm questioning about this is if they were diehard football fans, Bears or Packers, to schedule, you know, to have a Sunday funeral, it seems odd.
This is the travel back.
Oh, you were traveling back on Sunday, so you missed the game.
Okay, so the funeral was on Saturday.
Yes, traveling back. Meeting with family. Family was there, drove back late Sunday night.
Did you listen to the game on the radio on the way home?
No.
So totally missed it.
Yep, totally missed it.
Freshman year in high school.
Yep.
This is a tough one because, like, I feel like you threw the grandmother in there. That's a sentimental thing,
you know.
I am going. I don't know about you, Lieber, but I am thinking that this is a lie.
I also think it's a lie.
What is it? What is it?
we're
going with lie.
It is a lie.
Yes.
Missed some games here and there throughout the years. Let's see. This year, missed a couple, but I was watching on my phone. So is that technically missing?
No, you're still kidding.
You watched it. Yeah.
Had some banquets, you know, that I had to go to that missed football games, things like that. So I try not to miss.
For poops and giggles here, why don't you read us your true then?
The true?
Yeah, read us the other one, the true one then.
I wish you guys would have picked this one. I used to play the violin.
Oh, wow.
Oh,
yeah. Really?
Yeah.
So when did that quit? When did you stop that?
Oh, start of high school, stuff like – because my brother and sister both played, and it was kind of like one of those things like you need to pick an instrument. Once you got to fifth, sixth grade, so it's kind of like, okay, what do I know? And then I just went with that because, you know, follow in the footsteps.
So do you don't have one at home that you just dabble with anymore?
I don't. My parents do, and I've tried it since, and nothing was retained. Nothing. Maybe I should try to learn again.
That That would have been a hard one to guess, lie or true.
I know.
I mean, that one would have been challenging. Like, it seems so far-fetched that I would have guessed truth probably, but that is a difficult one.
Well, I almost just was like, okay, and just read it just because I wanted you to choose that one. But, you know.
I see. But you're playing
the game. Play by the rules.
All right. So I will go next. So, Lieber, you can't really see these papers very well, but I have two separate ones. Here it is.
I don't believe
it. One, two, one. All right, I will let you pick the number.
I'm going to go with also number two.
Number two.
When you lean back right there, you just disappeared.
Yeah, just the paper. Did.
Oh, shoot.
No, he totally disappeared.
Yeah, but it might have been the paper. See? Okay. I don't know. All right, number two. When I was a kid, I was swimming with a full diaper. When it came undone, causing my father to dive for the droppings.
I tell you what, Mr. Lieber, so it's a story.
Yeah.
Kind of detailed. Are those fake details to put us on? You know?
Well, like, did you get in trouble?
No, I did not get in trouble.
How old were you?
I was probably
12.
It was actually last week, and it was my wife did it.
Gosh darn it. Not again.
Well, then it's true.
Yeah, she. I do have a little problem, so I wear a diaper, but that's out there now. I was
at least you're wearing the diaper, though. That's the key.
I was probably 2 years old or around two.
I mean, who hasn't done that, right? Am I right?
Ooh. I think that,
Don't go too quick now.
No, I'll give it a second. I feel like every one of us has done that.
Really?
At some point. Well, I can't swim, so I didn't do it in a pool.
Hold on.
So I didn't do
was
it
that
in a
one
pool,
of your...
I would have done it, like, in my living room or, you know.
You dropped your diaper in a living room? Yeah.
Like I took it off in the living room. Yeah, absolutely.
I just keep thinking back to a famous movie that this happens in the pool and Bill Murray cleans
it. I haven't seen it. Have
you haven't. That's why I'm not saying the title.
Yeah. Caddyshack.
He picks it up. And it's a candy bar. But,
yeah. It's a Baby Ruth.
So what did he use to collect?
He had a t-shirt on and just kind of went down and scooped them in his shirt and brought them back to the surface and put them in the garbage can. Little marbles.
Right, you're at a pool?
Yes.
A public pool?
Yes.
Ooh.
Okay. What time of day was it?
It was actually in Wisconsin Dells, the Flamingo Hotel. Pool is still there.
So this would have been back.
Is it shaped like a flamingo by chance?
It was. The pool was not. Okay. No, not the 50s. We're talking. It would have been like 1978. So diapers were made a little differently than they are today. Mm. Probably
so
not as secure.
Right. Here's why I'm. What kind of pool was it?
I mean, regular pool? Indoor pool.
Regular pool.
Yeah, regular swimming pool at a hotel.
Now, indoor. Things were a little bit different back then. Parenting styles, not saying one was bad or, you know, good.
So you're saying my parents were bad parents. Is that what we're kidding?
offense. That's how you start it.
Like,
no offense, and you can't take offense.
But who lets your kid swim in a diaper?
Exactly. Well, you're – but in the pool by yourself.
In trouble.
But in your pool by yourself at two.
Okay, but here's the deal. My mom was with me. My mom refused to pick him up when the diaper broke and made my dad do it. It's really what happened.
Kind of forgot that detail, huh?
Well, nobody asked that. I mean, I'm just keeping it general. You guys are supposed to interrogate me. I'm not supposed to interrogate myself, for crying out loud.
Be better if you did.
Like Holmes and Watson here, I feel like.
Yeah. I'm ready. I've got my prediction.
Yeah. I think that's
I think he's telling the truth.
I feel like I'm leaning towards that, but I feel like he's trying to persuade it the other way. So I'm going to go, that's a lie.
Those are your final answers.
Yes.
It is absolutely true.
Yeah,
I'm saying. 2-0, baby. Let's go.
He's absolutely true.
What's
and the pool is still there.
The Flamingo.
And we've been back there a few times and kind of, we never reenacted it or anything.
Well, I was going to ask if you reenacted.
Did they stop
it
and sanitize or they, everybody? No,
we were actually the only ones there. And my mom picked me up and actually ran me out of there while my dad fished out the little marbles and we took off. So my dad was left there by himself fishing for marbles as my mom took me back to the room.
Oh, that's great. It's good stuff.
Yeah. So it is true. My false one was actually when I was a kid, I ate rabbit droppings out of a cage thinking they were raisins.
See,
that actually didn't happen to me, but I know somebody that did do that. That was my story I was going to tell. So,
And you can't say who that person was or?
No, because that'd be embarrassing to say that.
That'd be great. That'd be great.
Who eats rabbit droppings out of a cage?
What's going on down there? Mr. Lieber's looking around. Is the light above you going out?
I don't know.
I think
he's
storming
out.
He's feeling the pressure, I think, a little bit. All right. So, Mac, you are going to choose Lieber's number.
Well, I'm kind of mad that I missed that one. You guys should have let me go with my sunglasses. I don't think you guys would have been able to guess it.
I would never, well, like to play a violin with those sunglasses. I don't know.
Why is this?
It keeps disappearing. I can't.
I know.
I have to read what numbers they are.
There's no more lawnmower.
Hold it up so I can see what numbers are there.
Well, it's a two. It's pretty simple.
I'm joking.
Pretty simple.
So we went with twos on both of them. So we might as well go with number one just to, you know.
Change it up.
Keep the body guessing.
All right.
Okay. Struck out to end a Little League baseball game and broke my own nose because I was so angry.
Hold on. Did you say? Oh, man.
Like, okay, when you say broke your nose, not like when the swing was so bad when you missed the ball that you broke your nose.
No, out of anger. Okay. Anger.
See, I was picturing that before he said out of anger. I was thinking the swing and just the forearm. That's what broke it.
Did you happen to bat ninth in the order and play right field at that age?
I hit second, and I played first base. Okay. I was a little lefty.
Hold on.
Pull it to right field. Baseball was my favorite sport growing up.
I understand that, but what first baseman hits second?
Someone who can't hit a home run. I was a slap hitter who couldn't run. Yeah.
Well, obviously you didn't hit very well if you struck out to end the game.
Yeah. Well, exactly. The tying run was at second base. This is like third grade. Okay. So this would have been like 2005.
So you were still playing with a tee then?
No, it was live pitching. It was the first year of live pitching.
Coach pitch.
Great.
And for those of you out there, that is the same year that what team won the World Series, Mr. Lieber?
That would be the Chicago White Sox.
I just wanted to throw that out there. I heard 2005. I had to go. All right.
Oh, yeah. Dear.
So I struck out.
You did? Yeah. I want to see
the reenactment.
Yeah, can you kind of replay it here?
Can you stand back and do a swing?
Yeah.
And then –
yeah, I want to see a swing.
I need to see the swing.
Can you get rid of your virtual background for a second so we can see you swing? No, we can see you. Okay, yeah, you're good. Yeah, we can see it.
It's in my trunk.
No, just swing. Wow. Let's just see a swing.
Okay.
So that was like that was like a check swing.
Yeah.
Did I go, Mac? Can we feel
I'm going with didn't even play baseball watching that.
What?
Did you play violin?
No. Did we switch our papers?
I did. I did eat little marbles, though. But I didn't.
You didn't. But you didn't do the reenact. I want to know how you broke your nose. Like,
oh yeah, let's see that.
Like, you don't swing this.
Story. I want to explain the story. No.
Okay.
So I swung and missed. I struck out. I was crying my eyes out. I started hitting myself in the head with my hands.
With the helmet on.
Yes.
Okay.
And then I took my helmet off and I punched myself in the nose and had to go to the emergency room.
Punched yourself in the nose?
Yes.
Did your parents get you counseling after this?
No, not until later on.
Was it bleeding?
Yes.
Like
I had to go to the ER. Yeah.
Did they have to set it and stuff?
Yes. Like I had to get it. I'm not going to reenact that part, but like. you know.
Who saw this? Everybody or?
Yes.
Were you kind of like walking away on your own and just.
Like the whole team saw it. I mean, everybody saw it. My parents were mad because it was the 8 o'clock game. So this is at like 9:45 on a Thursday night in the middle of June. And I had to go to the ER.
Was this the last game of the season?
No. I was just that passionate about I was that passionate about baseball, but
just a regular season summer league, third grade.
Did you miss any games after that?
No.
So you played?
I played like a warrior. Yeah. Well, we didn't play again until the next week, so I had a few days to.
Did you get made fun of at all for that?
Oh, absolutely. Yeah.
Yeah. How did you handle that?
Oh, terribly. I just had to wear it. I mean, you know.
Were
your eyes? That was when we had to wear helmets with the, I don't know, what do you call it? The cage when we played Little League. I'm that young. Like, we didn't wear helmets without the, you had to have a cage even in baseball. So I could still play because I just put that on.
So the helmet was off when you did this then, obviously.
Yes.
Yeah. He did the two hits.
Oh, yeah. And then took the helmet off. Like, yeah. Okay.
So it's like you're doing the, you know, like NFL players when they get in a fight, they've got a helmet on, they decide to take it off and then start swinging. Like, if you would have just kept the cage on, you know, maybe now, but now you might be broke my hand.
Broke my hand instead of my nose.
Right. Of course. Have you hit yourself in the nose since? Or did you learn the lesson?
Not in the nose. The head, yes. Not in the nose, though.
Okay. This story might just be so crazy that it's true.
I would almost have to go with true.
I'm going with true, and I'm probably going to be wrong and go 0-2. But
put your sunglasses on for luck before you say that.
But if I put them on now, I'm going to second guess the true, and maybe I should go.
I'm going to go true.
Maybe I'm, you know, you haven't missed one yet. I have, so maybe I should just stick with true then, right? Would that be? I'm gonna go right. True.
We are true.
It is true.
Yes.
Yeah.
Matthew saved face here by getting one right.
500.
So that did happen.
500.
Yeah, 2005. My false story. Was
I want to know more about this Little League story though. I want to go deeper into that.
Oh, I took a freaking butt chewing when I got home. Well, I'm sorry, I took a butt chewing on my way
in the car ride.
Yeah.
What were you thinking? Was there ice available?
My dad doesn't yell, he's more of a calm, like I'm disappointed. My mom is a screamer. I mean, she she was letting me have it. I mean.
I'm kind of like your dad in that way then. I would have just
been son.
Just kind of shake your head at like
what were you doing?
Yeah, like the stupidity, be like
you could take yourself into the ER.
Mom was gonna hit me again. Yeah. I had a jaw in.
Well, she could have fixed it maybe, and then you wouldn't have to go to the ER if she would have the other way.
Did anybody like scream or cry in the stands?
No, I don't think anyone cared about me as a player that much.
Well,
yeah. Well, you struck own, out. You team, lost yeah. the game. You
your
lost
own
the
team
game.
Probably was pissed at you. He's like, probably deserved it.
What'd you say?
They said they all probably thought you deserved it.
Okay.
You just lost the game for him. God. Could you make contact? Number two hit.
They're probably surprised you were able to hit your nose after missing that pitch. So did you have to swing like three times to hit yourself in the nose?
That mid-40s fastball in the upper half is really hard
up? Couldn't get to
contact
that
with.
Did you choke up and try to just make contact, or are you swinging for the fences?
Yeah, it was a contact swing with two strikes, you know.
And the tying run on second.
Yeah, he shook off the curveball, went with the mid-40s fastball.
The heater. Give him the heater, Ricky.
Who was it? Was this Carterville playing somebody here?
No, this is Carterville playing Carterville. So, like, all my friends are here. Friends on the same team, friends on
the other. The story gets better.
We didn't have travel ball. I live in the boonies.
Yeah.
So you just played Carterville every week? See you guys next Wednesday.
No, there was six teams in a league.
Six Carterville teams.
Carterville 1 and 2.
No, we didn't travel to freaking Kentucky and play.
Yeah.
So my false one was that my – it wasn't that good, so I'm glad you picked one. It was that my first day I had my driver's license, I got it suspended for running through a stop sign going 30 miles an hour.
On purpose, or you just paying
on purpose? The story was that the cop pulled me over and said, how come you didn't stop? And I said, I get better gas mileage. And so he took my license away. Yeah.
I would have known that was false.
Yeah.
That was your saying?
I would have told you that one.
That was a good thing, because I feel like you couldn't lie very well, that we would be able to read you pretty easily.
Right.
I'm kind of disappointed. I've never heard that. I keep going back to this punching the self in the nose broken.
Well, thing. I don't want people – none of my kids – well, not until now. Nobody at Tri-Valley knows about that.
It's out there now.
Yeah. Yeah, it's out there. My nose has been broke by myself. Yeah.
Oh, that's good stuff.
Well, thank you guys for playing True Confessions. I'm sure the plan is to bring some more episodes. So we're signing out this week for True Confessions. Everybody give a goodbye.
All right. Have a good one.
And we're good. See you guys.